Differentiated teaching and learning responds to the diverse learning needs of all students. Differentiation requires a proactive mindset with the belief that all students can learn. It begins with advanced planning based on knowing students and using a range of data to identify where they are in their learning. Teachers continuously monitor student progress and adjust their teaching in response. Effective use of differentiation at the whole class level is important for student engagement and can help to prevent behavioural issues. Sometimes, behavioural issues are a result of barriers to engagement, such as a mismatch between the task and the student's current level, or students perceiving that they are unable to engage with the task. If you observe off-task behaviours in the context of academic demands, ask, what barriers may be present which are preventing the student from engaging? Here are some examples of adaptations to teaching and learning. In maths, some students work on single-digit multiplication, while others work on multiple-digit problems. In English, students construct simple sentences or write an extended paragraph. Students are allowed to choose the order to complete tasks. Students can work individually, in pairs, or in flexible groups. Students have access to equipment such as stand-up desks. Teaching to so-called learning styles, such as being an auditory, visual, or kinesthetic learner, does not improve student learning outcomes. Instead, select the modality best suited to each task. Think about the following scenarios. Patrick's academic record and most recent formative assessment shows that he can write simple sentences, but is still developing skills in extended writing. Which differentiation strategy would best suit Patrick's needs? A. Give Patrick more time for writing tasks. B. Provide a graphic organizer to scaffold construction of extended texts. C. Allow Patrick to choose a topic to write on. Several students lack confidence in attempting math problems. Test data and teacher observations indicate some gaps in knowledge of basic operations. Which differentiation strategy would work best for this group? A. Provide access to manipulatives and start with easier problems. B. Allow students to do the task in pairs. C. Use real-life examples in the problems presented. Plan learning units and tasks that are responsive to the needs of your learners. Seek guidance from specialist staff such as learning support teachers, inclusion teachers, therapists, and principal advisors. Ask parents and students for their input. Work collaboratively within a diverse team to plan learning activities and monitor student progress.